this is what I want to share with you today. I want to talk about the two-hole draw. I couldn't sleep last night. I was thinking about this. And we've talked about how to get a good solid tone with no vibrato, how to adjust your embouchure. We've talked about how to get vibrato. What we haven't talked about is one of the real secrets of this instrument. And this is one that Nat showed me early on. And so I want to show it to you. And here's what it is. Let's say you know how to get that two-hole draw and you want to articulate it. So the first thing to do, obviously, when you've got the strong single note is to use your tongue on the roof of your mouth, right? And you go da-da-da-da-da-da, kind of like going da-da-da-da-da-da while you're breathing in, right? Well, so this is stage one. And what I want you to do is I want you to tap your foot or tap your hand for three beats. On the fourth beat, breathe out and get all that air through the harp, but also loosen your lips a little bit and get it around the harp. Now you'll notice I went on the out chord on that fourth beat. Okay, now that's stage one, but there's, you know, stage two, three, four. Anyway, let me show you the next stage, because this was the revelation for me, is how to keep the beat on that two-hole draw and get a little bit of chord action going, okay? So this is what we just did, and this is what I do. And this is what Dennis Grunling does. And that's also the second thing that Dennis does. That's what Nat Riddles was doing. Now, what are we doing? What am I doing? What are they doing? And why is it different from what you're probably doing, which is just the two-hole draw without any of that little jazzy action going on around the sides? Well, what I'm doing, I'll slow it way down. It's starting to rain again. Harmonica lesson on a rainy day. Is I'm going da 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 da, or da di da di da da, breathing in. And every second time, I'm opening my lips a little bit, and I'm letting a little bit of the one hole and the three hole come in alongside the two hole. If I slow it way down, you'll hear what I'm doing. Look at the side view. There was a kind of goldfish called a kissing gourami, and they kind of opened their lips a little bit. Well, that's sort of what I'm doing. And by controlling the amount that you open your mouth, while you're tonguing, right? Every note is there, your tongue is still hitting the roof of your mouth. Right? Okay? That's how, as a lip-pursing harmonica player, I can make that sound. And it's wonderful. So here's some ways that I use it, and I'll actually throw in some other stuff around the side. Well, that's actually some other jazzy stuff I'll show you later on. All right, I'm running out of time, but I want to tell you what Nat and what I think Dennis and the other tongue blockers are doing. They're getting pretty much the same sound. Some little differences, but I wouldn't worry too much about them. Dennis and I argue about this. He thinks it's all about tongue blocking. I think it's more about lip pursing with little tongue blocking thrown in. This is a place where I do it differently than him and differently than my teacher. But this is what those guys are doing. They're putting their tongue on the piece of wood to the left of the one hole. This is if you're using a marine band, right? Key of B flat. And they're also letting that tongue cover the one hole. So the harps are actually kind of in the corner of the mouth. And they're getting the two hole out of the right side of their mouth. And then they're doing the same thing I'm doing, but they're lifting their tongue off the harp instead of doing the kissing gourami thing. Hear that? Now, that's what Nat did. That's what Dennis does. That's what a lot of the best tongue blockers is, what Big Walter did. I simply found my own way of creating that sound, lip pursing. And that there's a lesson in that, which is that you need to make whatever technique somebody's showing you your own. So I think you ought to take this, run with it. So this is what Nat would do. Now, what's that little kick? That got to me. I said, what are you doing, Nat? What are you doing? So you're just kind of using the three hole and sliding off it, right? I'll show you more about that next time, but here's the way I do that, my lip pursing way. Now, before I end this lesson, we're going to do it in different tempos, right? You can do it fast. Let me just... Real slow. Lesson's over. I gotta come back for the next lesson and tell you what I was doing in that second part. All right? See you later.